Hello.
Hi, welcome to my YouTube channel. So I am Ashley, I'm Venturette, and today I have a special guest.
My pink culpa.
Special guest. She's always my special guest. My best friend, Jess.
Hello.
So if you don't know Jess, Jess is amazing.
Aww.
She's amazing for many reasons. She's smart, beautiful, she's also well-traveled, she's hardworking. You know, she
sometimes
we like can be bad influences on each other and just be like, do you want to go out to eat?
Yeah,
of course.
Always.
Yes. So I want to talk to you guys about Jess because, as you've probably seen, I've moved to Manchester, and the big question is, why move to Manchester?
Of all places that you've been.
Of all places that I've been to and that I could go to, why Manchester, England? Mm-hmm. And honestly, you guys, you're looking at right at her. This is why.
Miss Manchester.
So Jess here, she's my good friend. As I've said, she's a blogger. She's also a journalist. Mm-hmm. She's a fashionista. And she is also an entrepreneur. Yeah, so that's what I mean. She's hardworking. But okay, so now you know why I'm here. So let's just get to know a bit about Jess and how we met. So yeah. So Jess, do you want to tell how we met?
So we met way back in 2014, when we was both starting our kind of nomadic kind of travel journey, I guess, like trying to, I don't know, break the norm of normal life and just kind of get out there and see what the world is all about. At the time, I just finished university in London and I moved back to Manchester. I'd been to some festivals and I was all like high on life.
Going crazy.
Yeah. And then I was like, you know what? I just don't want to be in Manchester. I was living back at home and we all know how tough that is, don't we?
Yes, it is.
It's never good. Once you move back, you just can't do it.
You can't stay. You have to go again. Yeah.
And then I found a teaching job in Barcelona. I was like, that sounds funky. So, yeah, I think I moved out there in about 2 weeks. And then we was at the kind of meet and greet of the other teachers with the company that I was with. And ta-da, me. Ash was there.
Of course.
And you was there. And then which has been kind of the journey ever since, is from food. I think we was both really getting hungry waiting for the food to come out, and like me and you was like waiting at the front like, where is the food? and you asked a question like, when's the food gonna be out? And I was like, I know, when is it gonna be
and
out?
She responded, I was like, oh, someone that gets me.
Yeah. So, like, food as much as I do. And then we snuck out for some drinks, and because crazily, you couldn't go out for drinks, even though it was like 24, 23.
Yeah,
so
we were
fully
adults.
Yeah, so we went out for drinks, and then I kind of latched onto her and was like, you're not going anywhere, you're going to stay with me. And we stayed in Barcelona for like 6 months.
Yeah,
5 or 6 months.
Yeah, I was there for about 5 months,
yeah. And we like traveled around together. We went to like Tarragona, Girona, went to a festival. Do you remember that crazy festival?
Oh, yeah, in Sitges for Carnaval,
amazing.
Yeah.
And then we've just been really, really good friends ever since. Like, she does inspire me, and we work really, really well together. Not only as friends, but you know, kind of got that attitude of get shit done.
Yeah. Almost kind of like business partner kind of thing.
Yeah.
So that just kind of goes into as to, you know, why I came here was because, you know, it'd been 3 years since we had seen each other, and I moved back to Barcelona, sadly for just a short month. It was not long enough, but because I was there, Jess was like, all right, coming.
Yeah.
So
I'd actually booked a flight, and then you wasn't there when I booked a flight, so I rebooked a flight and went, literally, I think it was like a few days later.
It was a few days later. She's like, I'm coming Monday, and it was like a Thursday. I'm like, okay, great. Like,
but it'd literally been about 3 years, but it was like a moment never passed, hadn't it, really?
Yeah.
And since, like, before that time, like, we'd both gone off and just kind of done our own thing. Like, when I left Barcelona, I moved to Bristol for a little bit, and then I moved to teach English in Thailand, and you was in Turkey.
Yeah, I was in Turkey at the time, yeah.
And then from there I went to Vietnam, and then from there, where did I go next?
After Vietnam, I Thank you, went back for a while. You went back to Bristol, yeah.
To Bristol, and then back to Manchester, then to Ibiza, and then back here for a little bit.
Yeah, so it's been a bit of a crazy couple of years,
but we've always stayed really good friends and like chatted, and you know, but you was on different continents at the time, and
yeah,
you know, it was it's really hard to stay that close when you. When you do live far apart, but I feel like people who are supposed to be in life do come back to you.
Yeah, and now I'm here. Well, first, like, she came and saw me in Barcelona. Like, I remember we did some work together in Barcelona, like, for the whole week.
Yeah, my jewelry brand.
Yeah, so stay tuned. Mm-hmm. You'll definitely see more of that coming soon. So we worked on that together, and it was one of those things that we're like, we thought of this years ago. Doing like work together, and then we came back together.
We didn't know how to channel it though. We just have lots of ideas.
Yeah, but we didn't know what to do. I think we were scared. We didn't really know how to do it. And now that we're a little older, wiser, we're like, okay, we got this.
So that's why we decided to come together. And now you're here in Manchester.
Yes.
You stayed with me for a little while.
I did, and she's like the best friend. Not only did she pick me up at like 7 in the morning on a weekday, she came, picked me up, made me
a pancake. Oh, no.
No, it was like a vegan English breakfast. Yes, made me breakfast.
I do a very good vegan English breakfast.
She does, and she does.
I eat it all day.
Yeah, and she does make nice pancakes as well. She made them later. I think we had it for dinner later that day.
We like to switch it.
Yeah, we like to switch it up, you know? But yeah, and then she came to help me, like, find a place to live. She came, not only did she, like, send out messages to people, but she came with me to each place.
Of course. Gotta make sure you look after your besties.
Yeah.
Because it is so hard to have them kind of friendships when you are a bit older.
Mm-hmm.
It is hard to find, like, good friends.
Yeah.
You know, especially when you've moved around as much as we have and you're constantly just thrown into new situations with new people, but then you get to know people and then you're leaving and it's like, you know, it's hard to remain close to people. So when you do have that connection, you know.
It's like you have to put in the effort, and I feel like we definitely have, and that's why we've stayed like such good friends throughout all this time, and especially like being back together. Yeah, so.
But for the future, I mean, we have a lot of things planned, and you know, I think it's good because you have to, like I said before, have friends who do inspire you to do better. And we never really just sit on our ass all day, unless we was a bit on go the other day.
which did happen when, like, I think my first weekend here.
Yeah, but that's gonna happen.
Yeah, it's gonna happen here and there. You have to live a little, you know, enjoy life.
Of course.
But yeah,
we get stuff done.
And we do.
You genuinely care about my work, and I genuinely care about your work. So it's like a, you know, it's not like someone's giving more than the other person.
Yeah. Like, we take initiative, because it's not like, oh, I support you. It's like, what have you done today?
Yeah.
Like, have you done this?
Yeah,
what have you done? What is on your to-do list today kind of thing? And it's like, oh, yeah, right. So it's like, we keep each other in check.
Yeah.
Which is really important.
When you teach online, you have your blog, and I have my blog, and quite a lot of other things, and it's overwhelming. So sometimes you need someone to check in with you and be like, what are you up to? Like, my jewelry brand, you know, it's pretty much there, but you know, like, you push me with it a bit because I need it. You know, you need to kick up the bum sometimes.
Yeah.
To be like, come on, what have you been up to today? And I'm like,
especially because I know, like, you know, I've helped in certain ways. Because so it's just like, okay, come on, like, we put in this work, let's, you know, put it out there. So it's nice because trying to be your own boss, I mean, it's like great and invigorating, but like, sometimes you need that push.
Yeah, it's tough.
Because there's days where you do get in a rut sometimes where you're just like not feeling inspired or you don't have any ideas. And when you have a friend or someone there to just
air it out with and chat and say, what do you think about this? Like, you, everything that I need help with, like, I'll go to you more than my own boyfriend.
No, and, like, vice versa, like, you know, because, you know, she's been blogging for the last few years, you know, she has done other projects, so I definitely, like, trust her 100%, like, for her opinion and her help, so I definitely always go to her as well, like, if I need any help with anything.
And now it's nice just to have you here to be able to go to things with and have a blogger buddy, because, I think I'd go on my own for years, or, I don't know.
Yeah, she'd be blogging about it and putting it on her Instagram story, and I'm like, I need to be there. She's like, come here, and now I'm here, like, after all this time.
Yeah. So, yeah, you can expect a lot more.
From the two of us, I feel like, yeah, so, like I said, I came here to Manchester because of this woman right here, because we have a lot of things that we want to do together and work together. So I wanted you guys to meet my best friend and see why I've came to Manchester of all places. So
yeah. And hopefully we'll have an amazing summer. We've got a lot of fun things planned.
We do. And so far the weather has been amazing, so I'm feeling like that's a good sign.
Yeah, you've come at a good time, to be honest, because wait till winter.
Yeah.
My people from Manchester know what I mean. Like, it gets dreary.
Yeah. And for my friends that are from Portland, Oregon, I mean, then you would relate, because it's just grey and gloomy and rainy.
Is it?
Yeah, just about all year round. But the summer is nice, so...
So summer's good, but yeah, winter. But hey, like, you'll be here till October.
Oh. Yeah, October, November. I'm here for 6 months. We have a lot that we want to accomplish in the next 6 months.
Stay tuned.
So if you like this video, give it a like and subscribe.
Forgot to say that. Damn it.
So I'll see you guys in the next one.
Bye.
Bye.